Hello students, hope you all are well at home and doing hard work to achieve the goals. Students, welcome back to the economics class of plus one standard. Yesterday we have started with lesson number 4, types of economies. And in this we have discussed the capitalist economy. Today we will discuss the topics socialist economy and mixed economy. Let's start with the socialist economy first. A system where means of production are owned by and managed by the whole community. Here the means of production means that land, labor, raw material, factories, banks, all these are owned by the government. The former Soviet Union, Cuba, North Korea, China, Vietnam are all the examples of the socialist economy. So means of production includes the things like factories, land, labor, raw materials and machinery. Means of production are owned by the whole society and operated by the public authorities, that is government, according to the economic plan for the benefit of the whole society. Here the word economic planning means that utilization of the country's resources into the different developments, like preparation of the budget by the government, and in this budget there is a planned expenditure for the different sectors, for the agriculture sector, for the industrial sector and for the tertiary sectors. So activities in accordance with the national priorities, like education is a national priority because it gives people hope, confidence and dignity, and it equips them with the knowledge and skills to escape poverty. Next one is, in the socialism, three essential things are there. First one is means of production in the hands of state, and second one is the use of resources is carried out through the planning. And third one is social welfare is the chief motivating force behind all the economic activities. The credit of making socialism and or the communism popular goes to the Karl Marx, who talked about the communist economic system in his book Capital. The Soviet Russia was the first country in the world to establish a communist economy based on the Marxian principles. Most of the East European countries also adopted the communist system after the Second World War. In 1917, the Soviet Union became the first socialistic state in the world. Next one is features of socialism. First feature of socialism is social property. Under this, means of production like land, mines, factories, bank, trade, etc. are owned by the state. Second one is government is the only producer. All the basic and the central problems are solved by the government. Social welfare. The government always seeks for the social welfare of the society as a whole. Economic planning. Under this, economic progress of the country is the responsibility of the central authority, under whose guidance and charge economic goals are achieved. The central planning authorities allocate all the productive resources according to the economic and the social goals set by it. Economic equalities. Next one is economic equalities. Under the economic equalities, the government gives an equal opportunity of employment to all. And sometimes the differences in the incomes are there, that is essential under socialism also because of the differences in skill, talents and productivity of the individuals. Absence of competition. Under the socialism, as government is the only producer, so there is no scope of competition among the different production units. Next one is less importance to the price mechanism. Under this, allocation of economic resources is made according to the predetermined plans. That's why prices are not determined by the forces of demand and supply, and much less importance to the price mechanism. People's cooperation. Under this socialism, the economy works with the full cooperation of the members of the society. Without people's cooperation, the planned targets cannot be fulfilled. Next one is, we will discuss the merits of socialism. First one is better allocation of the resources. Socialism is based on the motive of the welfare. So, objective of the production of the goods and services is shifted from more profitable goods to more useful goods. Allocation of resources is made by the central planning authority to promote the social welfare. Hence, luxurious goods are not produced at the cost of the basic necessities of life. So, there is no wasteful expenditure on the advertisement also under the socialism. Next one is social justice. Under the social justice, exploitation of man by man is eliminated. Equality of opportunity is developed there. Talents and get necessary training and education to everybody regardless of caste, class and religion. Next one is economic stability. Under the economic stability, there will be neither surpluses nor shortfalls. There will be no business fluctuations and no unemployment. Instead, economic stability it is maintained. Next one is social security and welfare. Socialists believe that people should be protected from the uncertain conditions of work, income and living, and the cost should be borne by the society as a whole. Therefore, the government undertakes various social security measures such as compensation of unemployment and accidents, sickness and maternity benefits, old age pensions, death grants, etc. And the state also provides the basic facilities like housing, education and health to the people. Next one is rapid economic growth. Under the socialism, the state adopts the economic planning. So, which is certainly a superior way of development as compared to the mechanism of price. Under the socialism, rates of savings and investment can be greatly raised, which are essential for the rapid economic development. Now, next one is demerits of socialism. First one is no incentives for hard work. Under this, people simply made to work according to the dictates of the central authority. And this renders the people to the status of mere wage earners. So, jobs are protected whether they are efficient or inefficient under the socialism. Second one is loss of freedom. Under this, you can't take your own decision. You have to wait for the government decisions. Next one is loss of efficiency. Under the loss of efficiency, there is a lack of incentives to motivate the people to work hard and improve their efficiency. Next one is red tapeism. Red tapeism means that under the socialism, all activities are performed by the government and its officials, and there is a possibility of delay and wastage of time for performing different tasks. File can move from one place to another, but work it as it is there. That is known as a red tapeism. Next one is concentration of economic and political powers. Socialism leads to the concentration of both political and economic powers in the hands of the government. Government has absolute authority in the country, which increases the power of the governments over individuals. Now, next one is mixed economy. A mixed economy is a form of capitalism and socialism. The concept of mixed economy is the recent origin. It is propounded by the J.M. Keynes during the World Depression of 30s. World Depression of 30s means that there is an international financial market collapse in 1930s and the largest stock market crash in American history. All these leads to unemployment and poverty, especially in the United States of America. That is the meaning of Great Depression of 30s. Two types of mixed economies. First one is mixed capitalist economy system or mixed economy. Mixed capitalist system like UK, USA, Germany. Under this type of mixed economy, the means of production are ownership of private entrepreneur and the government intervenes in the economic affairs are not directly but indirectly. It regulates and controls the activities of the private enterprises through direct controls like price control, licensing system, control over imports, etc. and monetary and fiscal policies. Monetary policies related to the bank rates and the fiscal policies related to the imposition of the taxes. In such type of economy, the government does not take over the means of production. And if it does, it will relatively on a small scale. That is why such type of mixed economy is called the mixed capitalist system. Now, next one is mixed economy, like India, where the existence of both private and government ownership, it is there. Government not only regulates and control the private enterprise through the various types of direct controls and appropriate monetary and fiscal policies, it also directly participates in the production of various goods and services. This type of economy exists in most of the developing countries like India. Indian economy is the best example for this type of economy. Now, next one is features of the mixed economy. First one is coexistence of private and public sector. In this, banking, transport, energy, etc. are fully controlled and managed by the state and kept beyond the reach of the access of the private entrepreneurs. And on the other hand, agriculture, consumer goods and industries like sugar, oil, textile, etc. are left for the private sector, which is wholly controlled and managed by the private individuals. The private sector enjoys necessary freedom and initiative, but within the framework of the national economic interest. Public sector dominates in those fields of production which requiring huge investment with low rate of profitability. And the private sector dominates in the economic fields like agriculture, consumer goods industries and trade, etc. Next one is economic planning. In the economic planning, the sectors are required to bring about a balanced growth of the economy, and the planning is in the form of various incentives and disincentives through monetary and fiscal and trade and other kinds of policies. Such planning is termed as the planning by inducement. Next one is beneficial for masses. In this, prices are generally regulated or administered prices are there in the economy. The state helps in lowering the prices of mass consumption goods and services, like the fair price shops are there. Undesired fluctuations in the level of prices, like uncertainty of supply, artificial scarcity, etc., are properly checked and removed by the government. Now, next one is greater social welfare. Under this, the government undertakes various social security schemes to help the poor and the backward classes. Like it provides various facilities, education, health and sanitation to the poor people. The government protects the interest of the workers by formulating various labor laws, factory acts, fixing the working hours and minimum wages. State tries to provide large employment opportunity to the workers. And it undertakes some measures to minimize economic and regional inequalities in the country. Next one is price mechanism. Under this price mechanism, in the mixed economy, it plays a dominant role. Sometimes the prices are determined by the market forces of demand and supply. Reduction of inequality of income and wealth. The state, by adopting the system of progressive taxation, levy of the death duties, etc., try to reduce the unequal distribution of income and wealth. Next one is merits of mixed economy. First one is proper allocation of resources. Under the proper allocation of the resources, properly divided among the private and public sectors, keeping in mind the overall interest of the economy. Advantages of the capitalist system. Second one is, in this the economy, all the advantages of the capitalist system are also provided to the business enterprises, and in this economy there is enough scope for the private initiative, self-interest and profit motive. Next one is social interest and welfare. The mixed economy will also secure the main advantages of the socialist economy in public sector. That is, social interest and welfare replace the self-interest and private profit. Public utility services, basic and key industries are kept in this sector. The government undertakes measures to check the production of harmful goods. Next one is good compromise between capitalism and socialism, also there in the mixed economy. Fast economic growth, it is there with the competition, everybody work hard and produce more at, and the cost of production, it is lesser. Next one is balanced growth, also there in the mixed economy, and flexibility also there in the mixed economy. Government can change the decisions according to the need of the country, and the government wishes to change certain industries from the private sector to the public sector, means nationalization of the industries can be there. Now next one is demerits of the mixed economy. First one is instability. As we have discussed earlier that in the mixed economy there is always a fear of nationalization, that is for the private undertakings. Next one is uncoordinated system. Under this one, mixed economy, there is a lack of coordination. In capitalism, coordination is being made by the price mechanism, and in socialism it is brought by the central planning authority. Next one is economic fluctuations. In this, the private sector industries are not controlled effectively and are affected by the short-term demand and supply factors, which results in the fluctuations in prices. Uncertainty. As in the mixed economy, industries in private sector always have a fear of nationalization. Next one is loss of efficiency. In a mixed economy, both sectors suffers due to the lack of efficiency. In the public sector, it is so because government employees do not perform their jobs with responsibility, and in the private sector, efficiency goes down because the government imposes too many restrictions in the form of control, permits and licenses, etc. Next one is India, a mixed economy. Indian economy is a mixed economy. Here both public and private sectors are in coexistence. In India, market mechanism has been playing a major role. Prices of the various commodities are determined by the market forces of demand and supply also sometimes. Government controls and regulates the sectors through its various industrial, monetary and fiscal policies. Adoption of the economic plannings in 1951 by our economy has been considered as one of the important characteristics of the mixed economy. Economic planning in India has mainly guided by the objectives of attaining higher rate of growth and employment generation and poverty alleviation along with the other objectives. So hope students you have understood this topic. Next we will discuss the distinction between the capitalistic, socialistic and mixed economies. First point it is, that is ownership. Under the capitalism, means of production are owned and managed by the private people. Under the socialism, means of production are owned by the government. And in the mixed economy, coexistence of state as well as private people are there. Next one is motive. Under the capitalism, self-interest and profit motive it is there by the entrepreneur. Socialism, as government is the only producer, so seeking for the social welfare. In the mixed economy, both social and profit motive both are coexist. Next one is instruments. Economic problems are solved with the price mechanism, that is prices are determined with the help of the forces of demand and supply. And in the socialism, government decisions with the economic plannings are there. And in mixed economy, price mechanism plus economic planning both are there. Occupation, under the capitalism, people starts business of their own choice, and in socialism, government is only the producer. And in mixed economy, limited sovereignty is there. Next one is competition. Under the capitalism, free competition among buyers and sellers it is there. And in the socialism, as government is the sole producer and no competition it is there. And in the mixed economy, there is a low degree of competition because of the existence of the government and interference of the government it is there. Next one is distribution of the income. Under the capitalism, large inequalities of income it is there. Richer becomes more richer and poor becomes more poorer. Under the socialism, very small inequalities of income are there. because government give the equal opportunities of employment and income to all, and under the mixed economy inequalities are there but lesser. Economic fluctuations are widely seen here because of the existence of the price mechanism, and in the socialistic economy no economic fluctuations are there because each and everything it is pre-planned. Economic fluctuations exist in the mixed economy. So students, hope you have understood the topic well. Now it's a time to note down the homework. First question, note it down. Write a note on socialistic and mixed economy. Second is, write the merits and demerits of socialist economy and mixed economy. Third one is, define the terms price mechanism and economic planning. And students, please go through the links also for more understanding. Thank you for listening, students.